Hello, welcome to the virtual platform of Udayanath Autonomous College of Science and Technology. I am Amita Patra, head of the department, Master of Commerce, Finance and Control, and you people are watching our YouTube channel, UN College Digital Classes. So we people are discussing the paper that is Financial Market and Instruments, and in that paper we are discussing a very interesting topic, that is Reserve Bank of India. And in the course of discussing that, we had discussed that what are the functions, and out of the various functions of the Reserve Bank of India, we are discussing the most important and vital function, that is the credit control function. In our previous lecture, we had defined that what is this credit control is, and what are the objective of the Reserve Bank of India behind the function of credit control. So basically, if we will say that this credit control function of Reserve Bank of India is controlling the money supply, Reserve Bank of India is controlling the supply of money into the market, whether it is pumping money into the market or it is restricting money in the market. Or we can say in other words that it is pushing money into the market or it is restricting or pulling the money from the market. Now, in today's class, we will be vividly discuss that what are the specific tools and techniques that the Reserve Bank of India is adopting for this function of credit control. So, we will be discussing credit control measures or tools of Reserve Bank of India. So, the method of credit control in India and the credit control measures are broadly categorized into two categories, that is the quantitative method or general method, and in that the tools that are included are the bank rate or discount rate policy, open market operations, variable cash reserve ratio, statutory liquidity requirement or SLR, and refinance policy. Other category is the qualitative or selective credit controls, and in that we include a regulation of minimum margin, rationing of credit, moral suasion, credit authorization scheme, issue of directives, credit monetary arrangements, fixation of party wise ceiling on credit, publicity, direct action, post sanction supervision, control, and monitoring of credit. So, if briefly we will say that this credit control of Reserve Bank of India, or we can say the function of the credit control that the Reserve Bank of India is doing, it is doing it in two broad categories, and we are categorizing into that is some are the qualitative methods and the other are the quantitative methods. So, in quantitative method, what we are including, these are the methods or tools, or we can say the measures which the Reserve Bank of India is implementing or taking to control the supply of money in the entire economy. So, that is what the quantitative method is doing. And in the other hand, we have other specific measures or other specific tools that the Reserve Bank of India is adopting that are the qualitative method or selective methods. So, from the name only we can very much recognize that these are the methods which are applied by the Reserve Bank of India to control the supply of money to the specific sectors or segments, or we can say that targeted segments of the economy. So, this is what the quantitative method and the qualitative method of credit control of Reserve Bank of India is. Now, we will go in detail and understand that what are these tools and measures and how Reserve Bank of India is controlling credit through these measures. So, first we will see that what these quantitative methods are. In that, we have various tools that are bank rate or discount rate policy, we have refinance policy, we have open market operations, we have variable cash reserve ratio, and we have statutory liquidity ratio. So, in the quantitative method, the Reserve Bank of India is using 5 specific tools by which it is controlling the supply of money or it is controlling the credit of the entire economy of the country, that are the bank rate, the open market operations, the various reserve ratios, the statutory liquidity ratio, and the refinance policy. So these are the 5 measures or tools that the Reserve Bank of India is applying to control the credit or to control the economy or the supply of money of the entire economy. Now we will understand one by one that by this specific policy, how the Reserve Bank of India is controlling the supply of money. So what is quantitative methods? The Reserve Bank of India Act confers on the Reserve Bank of powers to control credit quantitatively. And these include bank rates or discount rates, open market operations, and variable reserve requirements. And we will be discussing one by one. The first one is bank rate or discount rate policy. So when we are talking of the supply of money, so we will quickly have a look that how the economy actually works, that we know about the aggregate demand and aggregate supply. Suppose there is greater demand and less supply. We can take an example. Suppose you go to the market and there is scarcity of, for say, potato. So the potato, you must be having some situations like there is some market sensation, like there is some strike and the transportation is interrupted, or there is some flood situation, there is some cyclonic situation. So at that situation, what happened, if you remember, that we'll take the example of potato for say, because that is the one which you people must have gone through or must heard of, that when you go to buy, suppose, potato, and there you ask for a bigger quantity of that. Suppose you regularly go for buying 5 kgs of potatoes, and due to that situation you want to go for 10 kgs of potatoes at that particular situation. So at that time, what happened, that everyone is having the urge to have that particular commodity. So that is the aggregate demand of that particular commodity is high, and the supply is that much, that the supply is restricted. That means the supply is less than the demand. So that situation when we are having, then the price of that commodity will definitely go up. If you will remember that when this type of situation occur, the price of the commodity goes up, isn't it? So that is, if we'll think in a bigger aspect, when we are talking of a economy, so when the aggregate demand of the economy is greater than the aggregate supply, then there is a situation which is excess demand. So when there is excess demand and less supply, so this put the economy into an inflationary situation. So in this inflationary situations, what will happen, that the prices of the commodity will go up, and the adverse might happen, that the demand is less and the supply is more, and that situation we are seeing as deflation or deflationary situation, and where the money in the market is lower. Okay, now you understand that how the economy is working. So in that situation, what is happening, this measures have been taken, and one of the that we are talking of is the bank rate. So bank rate is what? Actually, the rate at which the Reserve Bank of India is lending money to the commercial banks. We know that the Reserve Bank of India, we had talked in our previous lectures, that it is the apex body, or we are also saying that it is the banker's bank. So it will take care of the banks, or it is the one to whom the banks will look on. Okay, so when the commercial banks need money, they will come to Reserve Bank for taking money. And when the Reserve Bank of India is lending money to this commercial bank, it will issue the money, or it will lend the money in a specific rate of interest, that is called the bank rate. Understood? So the bank rate is the minimum rate of interest at which the central bank is ready to grant loans to commercial bank or to rediscount the bills of exchange. Hence, the bank rate is also called as the discount rate. So that is why the bank rate is also called as the discount rate. Section 49 of the Reserve Bank of India Act has defined the bank rate as the standard rate at which the Reserve Bank is prepared to buy or rediscount bills of exchange or other commercial papers eligible for purchase under the Act. Reserve Bank regulates credit of commercial banks and the general credit situation of the country by manipulating the bank rate. The exchange in the bank rate generally has the effect on the cost of credit available to the commercial bank from the Reserve Bank. And if the bank rate is increased, the cost of the lending rate to the borrowers increase, due to which the level of the borrowings of the banks is reduced. So what it is saying now, how the bank rate is controlling the credit, that we know that bank rate is the rate at which the Reserve Bank of India is lending money to the commercial bank. So now the interest on which the commercial banks are taking money, they will be issue further loans to its customers at a higher rate. Suppose, for example, we can say that the bank rate of Reserve Bank of India is 8%, for say. So now the XYZ bank is going to get money from Reserve Bank at an interest of 8%. So now what the commercial bank will do with this money, that it will definitely make money out of the money. So that is what the banks are doing, or the commercial banks are doing, that they will make money out of that money, or they will lend it further and they will generate money out of that. So to generating money or to have to increase the money, what they will do, they will definitely issue those monies or lend those monies to the customers at a higher rate of interest. So if they are getting the money at 8% of bank rate, now they are going to lend the money at more than 8% or say 10% or 12%. So this is the difference of that 8% and suppose 10%. So this 2% is the profit that a commercial bank is going to make. So if the situation is there that the Reserve Bank of India is going to control the credit creation of the commercial bank, and this is an inflationary situation, that means what? There is excess money in the market, isn't it? The prices are high, the demand is high, the supply is less, the money is excess in the market. So what it will do, the Reserve Bank of India will increase the bank rate. So when the Reserve Bank of India will increase the bank rate, definitely the commercial bank, when is going to lend the money, it will also increase the rate of interest to the customers. So when the borrowing cost of the customer will increase, they will definitely hesitate to take loans, and the money in the market will be controlled. So this is what, or this is how we can say the bank rate is controlling the credit. So next, we have another quantitative measure or tool of credit control, that is open market operations. So what this open market operation is, so open market operation of a central bank consists of purchase and sale of government and other securities in the open market with a view to regulate the supply of money. But in India, open market operations are used by the Reserve Bank more to give support to the government securities than to regulate the volume of money. The Reserve Bank of India can influence the reserves of commercial bank, that is the cash basis of commercial banks, by buying or selling government securities in open market. And if the Reserve Bank of India buys government securities in the market from commercial banks, there is a transfer of cash from the Reserve Bank of India to the commercial bank. And this increases the cash base of the commercial banks, enabling them to expand their credit. And if the Reserve Bank of India sells government securities to the commercial banks transfer cash to the Reserve Bank of India, their cash base will reduce definitely. So by open market operations, what we understand, that we know that Reserve Bank of India, we are saying that it is the bank of government or government's bank, isn't it? So wherever the bank is operating, so if you we will consider that the government is a person, then Reserve Bank is its bank. Understood. So now when the government is trying to sell or buy its securities, that is government securities, that is nothing but the government bonds, then the Reserve Bank of India is the one who is the representative to what? To buy or sell the government bonds. So we will understand it more clearly that suppose you must have heard about fixed deposits. So if the commercial banks are issuing fixed deposits. So what they are doing? They are pulling the money and from the people, from the customer, and they are taking the money and the people are giving the money to the banks for a fixed period of time, and the bank is giving them an interest in that fixed amount. That is what the fixed deposit. When we are talking of business, so in businesses also they are raising money from the people or public in terms of debentures. They are also somehow like that. They are also, people are putting their money for a fixed period of time with a assured sum in return, and they are given with a certificate, okay, so or a piece of a document. That is what the business are doing. Like that, the government is also having government bonds that the Reserve Bank of India can buy and sell, and that is done in an open market. Anyone can buy and sell, but most of the time, who are the buyers or the sellers, or from whom the Reserve Bank of India is buying and selling, are most, or the major participant are the commercial banks. So the Reserve Bank of India, when feels that the money is to be, or the credit is to be controlled, so what it is doing, so the Reserve Bank of India is selling the government bonds to pull fund. So when it will sell the government bonds and the commercial banks will buy it, they will invest money there. So they are not left out with more money that they will push into the market, or they will lend to the customers. Okay, and the reverse will also happen. When it want to push money, it will buy the what? Government security. So that is what the concept of open market operation of Reserve Bank of India is. That is how it is going to control the credit. And the main objective of this open market operations are to eliminate the effects of exports and imports to gold under tile gold standard, to impose a check on the export of capital, and to remove the shortage of money in the money market, and to make bank rate more effective. Also to prevent a run on the bank. So this is what open market operation is. Now another very important quantitative measure that the Reserve Bank of India is taking, that is SLR, or statutory liquidity requirement. So what is that? Under SLR, the government has imposed an obligation on the banks to maintain a certain ratio to its total deposits with RBI in the form of liquid assets like cash, gold and other securities. And this SLR is to maintain on a daily basis. And the present rate of SLR of October 2020 is 18.50%. Now we will understand that what this SLR is. So SLR is what? Statutory liquidity requirement, or we are in other ways also we are saying that statutory liquidity ratio. So what is that? According to the regulation of Reserve Bank of India, the commercial banks, they need to keep a certain ratio or a certain percentage of its total deposit in the form of either cash or any other liquid asset like gold, any security, okay, so any other liquid asset with themselves, okay. So that is what statutory liquidity ratio is. Suppose we can take an example that suppose XYZ commercial bank is there, and the total deposit, we can say that for say it is 1000, the total deposit of the day is 1000. Now out of this 1000, it need to keep the 18.50% as the present SLR rate of October 2020 is, that is 18.50% of that 1000 with itself. That is mandatory. It need to keep it with itself. Now, when the Reserve Bank of India need that there should not be more money available with the commercial bank to be lended to the customers or to be pushed into the market, what it will do, it will increase the SLR rate. So when the SLR rate will be increased, suppose we will say that it will increase from 18.50 to 20%. So now when the increase is 20%, now more amount of money is to be kept, or more ratio of liquid asset is to be kept with itself or with the commercial bank, and less money is now available for lending. So this is what the strategy of statutory liquidity ratio is implemented on the various commercial banks. That is another quantitative method that the Reserve Bank of India is adopting for the credit control. And this statutory liquidity ratio or SLR is if the fixed amount or the fixed percent that will be implemented to every commercial bank. Okay, so this is what the SLR is. Now, another one is the variable cash reserve ratio. So what is this? The Reserve Bank of India is legally authorized to raise or lower the minimum reserve that the bank must maintain against the total deposit. And this reserve requirement is subject to changes by the central bank depending upon the monetary needs and conditions of the economy. And variable reserve ratio refers to the percentage of the deposits of the commercial banks to be maintained with the central bank being subject to variations by the central bank. The cash reserve ratio of October 2020 is 3%. So this is another important tool, or we can say that this is another quantitative method that the Reserve Bank of India is implementing or adopting to control the credit, that is a variable reserve ratios, or we can say the very widely we know it as the CRR, that is cash reserve ratio. So, as we have discussed in SLR, that the statutory liquidity ratio or statutory liquidity requirement is the certain percentage of requirement that the Reserve Bank of India instruct to be kept with the commercial banks in form of cash or any liquid assets. The cash reserve ratio is that percentage of cash of the total deposit that the commercial bank need to deposit with the central bank. Okay, so if suppose a bank is having a amount of 1000 total deposit in form, it might be for in form of savings deposit, it might be in the form of current deposit, fixed deposit or recurring deposit. Okay, so in any form of when the bank is having the deposit, so on that net demand and time liability, the certain percentage, that is currently 3%, that 3% the commercial bank need to give to Reserve Bank or need to keep it with the Reserve Bank of India. And this CRR or cash reserve ratio is also same for every commercial bank. And every commercial bank need to deposit that percentage of its total deposit with the Reserve Bank of India. And when the Reserve Bank of India feels that this is an inflationary situation or deflationary situation, it need to pull the money or push the money, accordingly it will increase or decrease the percentage of CRR. Now, according to the situation, whether the availability of the money with the commercial bank will be more or less. So, for example, we can say that suppose currently the CRR is 3%. So, if we have 100 rupees of total deposit in a bank, it need to give the Reserve Bank of India 3 rupees. Now, it will be left with 97 rupees. Out of that 97 rupees, that 97 rupees also the bank cannot give for lending because it need to keep is that certain percentage of SLR. Suppose we will say that the SLR rate is 5%. Now, out of this 100, 5% means 5 rupees. Now, again, 5 rupees are need to be kept with the commercial bank itself. And now, after keeping 5 rupees, we are left out with 92 rupees. Now, this 92 rupees is available with the commercial bank, and with that, it can lend it to the customers, and it can generate interest out of it, or it can make money out of it. And if the Reserve Bank of India feels that it is an inflationary situation or there is excess money in the market, what it will do, it will increase this CRR ratio, and it will make the percentage of, suppose 3%, it will make it 10%. Suppose. So what will happen, that out of this 100, we need to deposit 10 rupees with the Reserve Bank, that now we are available, now we are left out with 90 rupees, and the SLR is SLR percentage is suppose 5%. Now out of this 100, 5% again we will have to keep with ourselves. Now the available money with us for lending will be 85 rupees. So now you can understand that how the increase of or the variation in the cash reserve ratio of Reserve Bank of India is controlling the credit. Next, we will see another important quantitative technique, that is a refinance policy. So under section 17 of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934, it permits the Reserve Bank to provide accommodation to commercial banks by way of a rediscounting of eligible bills or as advances against approved securities. But such lending is subject to the policy formulated by the bank in this regard. Banks cannot claim such facility as a matter of right. And the Reserve Bank of India has restricted the availability of its refinance to banks through the various method followed by it from time to time. So this is another important quantitative method of Reserve Bank of India, is that it is taking to control the credit, that is refinance. Now we will go to the qualitative techniques of Reserve Bank of India that it is adopting for the control of credit for specific sections or segments of the economy. So the Banking Regulation Act confers on the Reserve Bank vast powers to control and regulate the entire banking system of the country. And the Reserve Bank controls credit qualitatively by virtue of these powers. And the Reserve Bank has the power to issue directions regarding the rate of interest that they should pay on fixed and saving deposits, the rate of interest they may charge on types of advances, the types of securities they can accept as collaterals, the branch expansion program of the banks, and many other matters. And that is what the qualitative measure of the Reserve Bank of India is. Now, what is the objective behind this qualitative method of credit control? We will see. These are the following objectives. First is to divert the flow of credit from undesirable and speculative uses to more desirable and economically more productive and urgent uses. To regulate a particular sector of the economy without affecting the economy as a whole. To regulate the supply of consumer credit. To stabilize the prices of those goods very much sensitive to inflation. To stabilize the value of securities. To correct an unfavorable balance of payments of the country, to bring under the control of the central bank credit created by non-banking financial intermediaries, and to exercise control upon the lending operations of the commercial banks. So these are the void objective that the Reserve Bank of India is having on the method that it is applying through this qualitative method or through these selective measures. So So by that, it is controlling the economy not entirely, but selectively, where it feels that there is more inflationary situation in this segment, or it feels that this segment is needing more money, or more money should be pushed into this segment. So like that, there are these are the various objectives for which this qualitative or selective method of credit control by the Reserve Bank of India is done. And there are various specific tools like the quantitative method that are there in qualitative method that the Reserve Bank of India is adopting for the credit control. In our next class, we will be discussing in detail that what are these specific qualitative measures or tools that the Reserve Bank of India is adopting for the credit control. So for today, this is all. Keep watching. Our next video lecture is going to be very interesting. Thank you.